breaking news from Florida. One dead, 14 wounded. This week and this new year is getting off to a tragic start as the country wakes to horrific news this morning out of Florida, where emergency crews are on the scene right now, trying to save lives before more are lost. The death toll is currently at 1 confirmed, but 14 have been found wounded who are fighting to stay alive under truly horrible circumstances. As authorities work to put together the pieces of this tragedy, it's only a matter of time before President Donald Trump addresses the nation on the events unfolding right now. What was supposed to be an enjoyable time for people in New Port Richey, Florida, turned into a nightmare out of nowhere. Now, one woman has been pronounced dead and there could be more fatalities over the coming hours. What these people endured is unimaginable, and this part of the state of Florida needs the country's support right now. Fox News reports. At least one woman was killed after a casino shuttle boat went up in flames Sunday afternoon in the Gulf of Mexico off Florida, forcing more than 50 passengers to jump overboard into the shallow water. The woman died late Sunday hours after the fire began, while 14 other people were injured, Regional Medical Center Bayonet Point spokesman Kurt Conover said on Monday. The woman had gone home after escaping the boat when it caught on fire, but she went to the hospital's emergency room after she became ill. Other passengers experienced chest pain, smoke inhalation, and other injuries. Conover said 8 people treated at Bayonet Point have been released. Authorities responded to the scene around 4 p.m. after receiving a call the San Cruz casino boat caught fire, WTSP reported. The flames quickly spread, causing people to jump overboard into the shallow water. The 50 passengers made it to shore safely, where medics treated them, the news station added. Larry Santangelo, 57, said he had just driven into his neighborhood when he saw smoke and fire and thought a house, possibly his own, was ablaze. But then he realized it was the boat, which sat just about 100 yards offshore. It was so windy and they were soaking wet, said Santangelo, adding a woman collapsed when she reached the shore and vomited. He worried some might suffer from hypothermia. However, out of the ashes regular heroes emerged in proof that the human spirit is still alive. What Santangelo did as an immediate reaction to the deadly scene was an incredible act of kindness in the middle of a nightmare. While it may seem simple, it spoke volumes and deserves attention. Regardless of not knowing a single victim, Santangelo brought 30 strangers into his home to keep them warm, seemingly having been shocked by the scene of the woman he watched collapse on the beach and vomit. He clearly didn't want to see anyone else suffer these circumstances and perhaps save lives in his simple act of kindness. He brought all these people into his garage to warm up and seek refuge. Another witness to the horror was 19-year-old Bakar Jandali, who was at home with his family near where the fire erupted. They didn't have much time to decide whether or not to jump, said Jandali, 19. The fire was moving fast. It was a hard jump. Fox News continued. Port Richey Chief of Police Gerard DeCanio told the Associated Press the shuttle boat's crew detected engine problems and decided to turn back. Police released a photo and video showing the boat in flames, spitting thick black smoke into the air. The shuttle boat carries people back and forth from the Tropical Breeze casino cruise, which is offshore because it can't legally operate close to land. A representative for the casino declined Fox News' request for a comment. The loss of life could have been worse, but the fact that anyone died this way is terrifying. We assume all vessels are safe in this day and age, but this tragedy reminds us that's not the case. In the middle of this horrifying ordeal, it's amazing to see simple Americans step forward and think about their fellow citizens and do what needs to be done to help others out. While it may not seem like much, what Santangelo did makes him a hero and an excellent human. Not all hope in humanity is lost, and he proved that Sunday night.